Humberto back here. Welcome to the channel one more time. I am in Brazil right now, dealing with some family things and taking care of some personal issues. And I'm also taking advantage to take you guys a little tour of my place where I start everything. When I work with the bees for the first time, if you know a little bit of my story, I'm a second generation beekeeper in my family, and dad always asked me to help him. And at the beginning, I hate the bees a lot. So that's, I think, was a good time so I can give you a little tour and I can show you my first bee. And it's not the honeybee, it's mellifera. But that was my, so I think it's one of my favorite bees, and I think you're gonna enjoy it too. Let me give you a tour. House, the property. There is a little pool over there. Nobody's taking care of that too much. Of course, I'm not here. They always put me to work. We built the house ourselves. My hands and dad's hands. And we had, normally we don't have bees here anymore. Sorry about the noise and the wind. I don't have my stuff. I didn't bring my microphone and good gear for audio recording, so I apologize for that. We normally have a lot of bees here, honeybees, it's mellifera, in this area, the whole thing, and also the other area right there. We're gonna get there soon, but now it's a mess. Dad is retired, not doing anything, not doing very well physically to do the work that need to be done, so, and I'm not here, unfortunately. There is some things here. I have bananas, we have lemons, we have yucca, this yucca here, bananas, we have palms. We still have some nice trees here. But normally the apiary were here, and we have around 20 to 30 hives in this apiary. The other side over there, we have more, 20. And then we have located in all those places, we have a couple little hives here and there, depending on how the neighbors were happy about them. Normally they were not, because it's not easy to work with Africanized bees. I'll show you a little clip about a visit that I did yesterday to a beekeeper. And there was a cinematographer, and it was kind of fun to watch what happened. So I'll play the clip right now. Enjoy. I'll see you right there. I'm gonna show you the other side. Trying to do some things here, but not looking good as normally look at before. We still have some orchard here and there, but normally this area was all bees. We have plenty of bees. I will show you where we have now our little honey house, which is not a honey house anymore. I don't even know what they are using the things for. And more yucca, and just need to be careful here because I don't have my shoes on, and sometimes we have surprises here. So there's a lot of constructions now. We have neighbors. We never had neighbors before. The area is growing fast. A lot of properties being built. But this little thing right there, that was our little honey house. We extract and keep equipment and things like that. So this is also part of the area. the back of the house. We also have bees on top here. I also put some little nooks to capture some swarms on the top here, because there is, when the bees were here and everywhere, there is some swarms. I always like to keep some you know, some baits there and some box so they can go straight there. The only problem is to get them and put them down. Yeah, fun stuff. So yeah, the proper to keep going forever here. I'm not going there. It's too much going on. It's a nice place. And now what I want to show you is my first bees. I'm trying to find them. Oh, before the bee, I forgot to show one area that we also have lots of bees. And now I think Dad planted some beans and more yucca. He kind of like yucca a lot. As you can see, more yucca here. And again, we have neighbors now. It's so weird for me to see other constructions around here. I don't know what to think about that. I don't like it. Not that I'm antisocial or anything. It's not the same. So I also have a lot of bees here. There, the house there. And this little place that have water there. We have our honey house here and with equipment, things like that, but now we don't doing anything. So the idea now from my dad, that my wife gave me the idea, and I don't know why I didn't think about that before. We're gonna transform this whole place now. Instead of a mellifera apiary, we're gonna build a melipona apiary here. We're gonna have plenty of stingless bees, and we're gonna make honey from stingless bees. Very different taste, very good, very expensive. And Dad's not gonna have problem with stings, which is the most important thing, I guess. And then so they can still enjoy the bees without me being concerned that they're gonna die every day. Okay, so after a while, I finally find them. My first bees. These are Jatai. They are very small, eusocial bees, and they live all over here in South America and Central America. They're quite fun. And if you know my story, let me sit down. I can talk a little bit better with them. And the fun about them is that they don't have stings. So they're stingless bees. And when Dad pushed me to work with honeybees, Apis mellifera, I didn't like it at all. I think I mentioned that before in my stories. And these are the ones that I enjoy when I was a kid. After I got tons of stings from the honeybees, I normally come here and talk to them and say that they are the ones that my friend and things like that. Quite a lot of stories with them. They're quite fun. They have this tube, and by the size of the tube and the amount of bees on around that tube, you can have an idea about how strong they are. And the nest is inside this wood. I'm not gonna touch anything. I'm not gonna transfer them to boxes. We can. So then the main idea now here is to build for Dad our stingless bees apiary. We have hundreds of species, and it's gonna be quite fun to start this from scratch and do videos about that and bring and talk about the biology of this, all those species that we have here in South America. This is gonna be fun. Dad's excited. He was happy about it. Now it's gonna be able to work with bees again and without the problems of getting stung and almost die. So we are happy about that. I'm happy about that. So let me talk about a little bit about Jatai. Jatai, there is plenty of names. I don't even remember the other names, but there is seven different names. Abelha amarela. There is plenty of names. The only one I remember is Jatai. But It's not a melipona for the general melipona. It's from the tribe, if I remember correctly, meliponini. And the general from this species is Tetragonisca. So the species is Tetragonisca angustula. And it's quite fun. They're very small, they're eusocial, they have workers, they have soldiers, they have one queen. And when the time comes in the spring, they need to split. They build four or five drones only, so they can mate and move on. It's quite fun. We can put them in boxes. The honey tastes fantastic and it's very expensive. There is a lot of properties, antimicrobial properties, anti-inflammatory properties, and yeah, we're gonna talk about them when the time comes. Right now I came completely unprepared. I don't have my best gear to, and I'm really mad about that. So see, you got it. Now you know my first bees, the ones that I consider my friends when I was starting in beekeeping. I hope you enjoyed this video. Click the like button if you enjoy it. That kind of give me some help with the algorithm, the YouTube algorithm. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Inside the Hive.tv, the show about bees, including these ones. See you guys next week. Bye bye.